Once upon a time, in a kingdom far, far away, a new queen came to the castle. Unfortunately, what the king hadn't known was the queen was accustomed to being the center of attention, and she would get nasty when she didn't get her way. The king had arranged to introduce her to his only child, the princess.
Your Majesty, this is Snow White, the princess of the castle, and your new stepdaughter. Her parents left her on the doorstep, so the king adopted her as his own. She's beautiful and very well-behaved. Everybody just loves to hold her.
Cute. Here.
The queen finished her tour, bossed a few people around, and then, making sure nobody was watching, she went into her private room to talk to the magic mirror she had brought with her.
What's going on here, mirror? Why is everyone paying so much attention to that pale little kitten, hmm? You've always told me I was the fairest in all the kingdom.
Well, we are in a new kingdom, but from what I've seen so far, you've still got it. You're the top's number one queen of the hill.
I knew that. What with all my wonderful charms, no one will ever outshine me.
As the years went by, the kingdom prospered, and Snow White became a young lady who had many admirers.
Oh, look, it's her. Be still my heart.
Snow White got her name because she was the color of winter snow, but most people thought she was as warm as sunshine.
You know, I'm beginning to think she likes me. She baked me cookies the other day.
Yeah, well, she's been teaching me how to play chess.
She's got it all.
Tell me something? Okay, I'll follow you. You poor thing! Come on, I'll get you some help right away. Don't worry, you'll be all right.
What have you got there, Princess?
A baby duck. He's hurt his leg.
Oh, the poor little guy. He's shaking.
But it's probably just a sprain.
We'd better take him to the vet to have him looked at.
Oh, thanks. You're so sweet.
No problem.
He'll be all right now. He's in good hands. Our vet is the best.
Snow White will make a wonderful queen one of these days. She cares about everyone in the kingdom.
You're absolutely right, dear.
I don't like the sound of that. What's going on, Mirror? All anyone talks about is Snow White. Whatever happened to me, me, me?
You won't get mad.
Mm-hmm.
It seems your image has slipped. You're down. You're low. You're colder than snow. And speaking of snow, it seems like our own princess has now claimed the number one spot in the land.
Snow White? What has that perfect little princess got that I haven't got?
You promised you wouldn't get mad.
It's not fair! She wasn't supposed to grow up to be smarter and prettier than me. Oh, well, I know just how to take care of this problem.
The queen had always had a few tricks up her sleeve, and that night she set one of her nasty plans in motion.
You sent for me, Majesty?
Yes. Sir William, you are the king's knight of honor.
Yes, ma'am.
Very good. The king told me I could count on you whenever he's away.
Yes, I am at your service. My sword is yours. Careful, it's sharp.
Yes, your sword's perfect. It would scare anyone. Now, Sir William, I've got a special mission.
Your Majesty, as long as you are queen, your wish is my command.
That's good, because I want you to get rid of Snow White.
Majesty, surely you don't mean it.
Oh, I most certainly do. And if you want to be a knight and care for your family, I strongly suggest that you do exactly as I say or else.
But your Majesty, I can't hurt her. The king would banish me.
Let me take care of him. And besides, I just want you to scare her so she doesn't come back.
Yes.
And bring me proof.
So the next day, Sir William invited Snow White to visit a secret clearing he knew about.
so good. Oh, a butterfly. They're just so fluttery and pretty. They're such happy little creatures.
Kingdom's full of them.
Sir William, is this special clearing far? I'm getting a bit tired.
No, it's just over there, Princess.
Oh, great. I didn't know my father's kingdom was this amazing. I can't wait to tell him about it. Wow, a waterfall. Look. And just in time, too. I'm so thirsty. Oh, that's cold. Ooh.
If you want to be a knight, you'll do as I say.
Do you want a drink of water? It's really good. It'll cool you off. You seem a bit nervous. What's the matter?
If you want to care for your family, you'll do exactly as I say.
I'm sorry. Oh, please forgive me. I was wrong to obey the queen.
But why did you? And why would she want to get rid of me anyway? I don't understand.
Because you're a better person than she could ever be. She's jealous.
I always had a feeling she didn't like me that much. But I never thought my own stepmother could ask this. And why did you agree to do it? You've always been my friend. I know. I'll bet she threatened you so she could get you to obey her. I've seen
yes.
her do that plenty of times before. I always feel real bad.
You're right.
Wild boars, I'm scared.
They won't hurt us, but that does give me a brilliant idea, a plan.
What's that?
Nothing for you to worry about. Now, you're going to have to find a safe place to stay till your father gets back. Then I'll follow your tracks, bring you home, and then we'll get that nasty queen good.
Sounds good.
Now, you better go so you can find a place before dark.
Right. I'm on my way. Bye, Sir William. Thank you.
Take care, my princess.
Don't forget to ask Sad for the queen.
I won't. What a brave little lady. She's got courage. Now, let's fine-tune this plan.
Snow White ran deeper and deeper into the forest. It was so dark and scary that she was too afraid to stop. She ran clear across her father's kingdom, but she hoped she'd see the king again real soon. Meanwhile, Sir William had made it back to the castle, and the queen was in a very good mood.
Well, I'd invite you to join me for this celebration, but I really don't feel like sharing. This stew is wonderful. Imagine that. Snow White was carried off by wild boars. Well, you may go.
Thank you.
Sir William was happy to fool the queen, but he never wanted to face her again. Now he had to wait for the king to come back and hope Snow White was okay. Hadn't eaten since that morning, and all that running had made her quite hungry. She made herself a nice snack and felt much better. After that, she decided to look around the house to see if anyone might be napping upstairs.
Oh, seven beds, too. They must all share the same room. They're small, but soft. Huh? This bed doesn't fit me. I know.
Just as Snow White lay down to take a nap, the owners of the house were coming home.
What'd you do that for? Look at our house. The door's open. Hey, somebody's been sitting in my chair. And somebody's been nibbling on my bread.
And my bologna is missing a few bites.
Hey, come upstairs, you guys. Someone's up here.
Wow. Try to be quiet. We don't want to wake her up.
Where did she come from?
How did she get here? She's beautiful. She must be a princess. How did she find our house?
I'll bet you she's lost.
We should let her sleep then, and we'll find out more in the morning.
The dwarves were good hosts, so they let Snow White have the three beds, and they doubled up for the night. It's a good thing they were sound sleepers. The next day, they were all up bright and early.
Morning, miss. Rise and shine.
It can't be the morning. I only closed my eyes to have a nap.
It's all right. Tell us, what's your name, dear?
My name's Snow White.
Snow White. Oh, but what are you doing out here? Aren't you from the other side of the forest?
Snow White was well known even beyond her father's kingdom, so the dwarves wanted to hear her story right away.
Oh, you poor princess. Are you sure this is all because of your stepmother?
Yes.
Well, why don't we just march right over to the castle and confront her in front of everyone?
Because my father's gone. I have to wait till they come get me.
You'll be needing a place to stay then, won't you?
Yes.
Do you have any relatives?
Yeah, do you have friends or family you can stay with till your father gets back?
Well, perhaps you'd like to share our humble home.
Do you mean it?
We sure do. Right, guys?
Oh, yeah.
Thank you. You're so kind.
But you know, we all work pretty hard, and we take care of the house, too. We'll need your help. You won't mind doing your share, right?
Right. Back home, I have chores to do and everything.
You wouldn't know how to cook, would you?
Yes, sure. Cookies are my specialty.
You make yourself at home then, Snow White. It seems like we won't have to worry too much about you.
Yeah. By the way, I've heard you're real good at chess.
Boy, you'll make a great queen someday.
Oh, thank you.
That settles it then. We'll fix up the guest room so you'll be more comfortable.
Good idea.
Now, Snow White, I am sure I speak for all of us when I say you can stay as long as you wish.
Thank you.
Now you have a good afternoon, and we'll be back for dinner.
Right.
So, Mirror, now that I've gotten rid of Snow White, who's the fairest in the kingdom?
In the kingdom, that would be you, Majesty. Definitely you.
That's excellent. I knew I could count on you for the good news. Now I just have to make up a story that'll fool my husband.
Talk about being fooled.
What do you mean by that? Speak up, tell me.
Well, to be honest, you've really been fooled. Sir William faked it all. Snow White is in a safe place far away, waiting to come back and tell everyone the ugly truth.
I don't believe it. Oh, Snow White is still out there somewhere. Ugh, they can't do this to me. I've got to find her before the king returns.
Back at the dwarves' house, everything was as happy as could be.
Hi, everybody. Glad you're home.
Hello, princess.
Come on in. Your lunch is all ready. It's waiting right on the stove. You're all hungry, I hope.
Wow, you've been busy.
Oh, it's gonna be good. I can't wait. This smells really incredible.
Wow! You moved all the beds back. And you even had time to mend my shirt.
And fresh bread for each one of us.
Here you are.
Wow, piping hot soup. What a treat.
Just be careful. It's really hot. I wouldn't want you to burn your tongues.
I don't remember when's the last time we actually had a hot meal. I guess we've just gotten used to cold food.
Right. Since we're usually too tired to cook after work, we fix all our meals in the morning.
I understand. At my father's castle, we always say there's nothing like a good meal with a table full of friends.
You can say that again. Thank you, Snow White.
Anybody for seconds?
Oh, yes. I do. Snow White wasn't the only one cooking up a storm. Back in her chambers, the queen was making up a special recipe of her own.
We'll be down the road at the mine if you need anything.
Okay.
Now don't let anyone in while we're gone.
I won't.
Nobody knows you're staying here, but you have to promise us you'll be careful.
Promise.
Now you have a good day now, dear, and don't work too hard. You make us feel bad. Have a little fun.
I will. I'll just tidy up, and then I'll read a book.
Good idea. We got a whole bunch just gathering dust.
You'll be late for work if you don't get going.
We're on our way right now. You know where we'll be.
I'll be fine.
Bye-bye.
See you soon.
Well, at least that mirror gives good directions. He led me right to her.
Be right there.
Good morning, little miss. Can I interest you in some delicious apples today?
Oh, I'm sorry.
Oh, but these are delicious fresh apples that I picked myself this morning.
I'm sorry. It's just that I'm not supposed to let anybody in. I promise.
I'll just stay on the stoop then. Try one.
It looks really good. It's so big.
They're the best. You could make a delicious apple pie.
Oh, yum. That would be great. But I'm a guest here, and my friends didn't leave any grocery money.
Well, please accept one as a gift, then, as a little housewarming.
I'd be breaking a promise.
I'm sure they wouldn't mind if you just took half, then. You know what they say, an apple a day keeps the...
doctor away! Oh, yes, that's one of my father's favorite expressions. Oh, my friends won't mind. You've been so nice and it looks so good.
It's delicious. Here, it's yours.
Thank you.
Enjoy. Surprise. Oh. I got you.
Now you'll be out of my way for good, and you'll be asleep forever. The nasty queen had put a sleeping potion in Snow White's half of the apple. When the dwarves came home and saw the apple next to her, they knew what had happened. They were very sad and felt bad for having left her all alone. They built her a beautiful bed full of flowers so she could rest peacefully.
Our princess, you promised you wouldn't take anything from anyone.
I'll bet that queen tricked her somehow. We should have been there. It's our fault.
What's going on? Who's that? She's beautiful. She looks just like a princess. Tell me, is she sleeping? Did something bad happen? My sympathies. You must all be very sad, I'm sure.
It's terrible. And it's all our fault, too. It was done on purpose, but she's too sweet to be suspicious.
Yes, your princess was a very good person. A special person with a big heart to make friends with all animals. I should know. I've been traveling for a long time, and of all the people I've met, not many have that special gift. I don't understand. I don't believe that anyone could wish her anything but good. She looks pure as snow and warm as sunshine. Do you think I could stay a while? I'd like you to tell me more about her, if it's not too painful. I think I'd have liked to know her.
Yes, of course. Well, to start with, her name is Snow White.
Oh, that suits her so well.
She's a princess from the other side of the forest.
Really?
It turns out this young man was Prince Howard from a kingdom far away. They talked for a long time, and he felt as if he knew the princess by the end.
Oh, dearest Snow White, if only we could have met before.
My dear friends,
yes?
Do you think you could take the cover off of her bed so I could say goodbye to the princess?
I don't see why not. You seem to be a nice young man, and Snow White would be glad to be your friend. It's too bad you two didn't meet sooner. Let's put the lid aside, okay?
Thank you, sir. Yes, I would love to be your friend. Oh, sweet dreams, princess. You'll always be in my heart.
Oh, don't tell me. I fell asleep and took a long nap again, huh?
Not quite.
But we sure are glad you're awake now.
Welcome back.
What's your name?
I'm Howard.
He's the one who kissed you and broke the spell.
Huh? Well, actually, I thought I was saying goodbye, but it turned out to be hello.
Ah, the kiss of true love. That's what had broken the magic spell. Soon after the Prince and Snow White returned to the Prince's castle, they came up with a plan to fool the Queen once more. They decided their wedding party would be the perfect setting.
Mirror, I hear there's a party in another kingdom. Why wasn't I invited? Don't those people know that the fairest in the land is always first on the guest list?
Oh, but my queen, the fairest in the land, is the one who made up the guest list.
What's that? I don't understand what you're talking about.
The lady in question didn't want you spoiling her party, so she deliberately left you off the guest list.
Ah, but everyone knows I never miss a social event. Well, I'm sure I still have plenty of time to get there. I'll be able to make a really grand entrance.
Snow White's father and the prince's parents had made all the arrangements for the party. They wanted their children to be happy and enjoy this great day, so they had everything worked out for the queen's arrival.
Now, let me see who this little lady is who thinks I'm going to spoil her party. Impossible! Snow White is here? Oh, but how could she? And she looks so happy. She found true love. I knew I should have used a different potion. I'm so mad.
Halt!
What? Let go right now! How dare you!
This is a private party. You're not welcome here. Snow White told the king the whole story. They're waiting for you right now. Let's go.
You're making a big mistake.
The only mistake had been putting up with the queen for so long. Once she was gone, everyone lived happily ever after.